This is something that a lot of service providers don't really talk about, and I wanted to take some time and actually walk you through this process so that you're able to start tracking any traffic that you send to your website.
All right, let's go ahead and get your Google Analytics 4 account all set up so you can start tracking your website data. If you are brand new to Google Analytics, then you probably just need to do a quick Google search and type in Google Analytics, and then you'll see this accounts.google.com sign in. Just go ahead and just press that to sign in. If you do already have an account, the process will be very easy because you just are just going to type in your email account. If you have never had a Google Analytics account at all, you're going to probably have to have it connected to one of your email accounts for business. And I would do that. So my account is connected to my Jamar at email account for my business. And so go ahead and do that. Set that up. Signing up for a Google Analytics account is very easy to any other type of account. But once you finally log in, most people, they may have had Universal Analytics. And so I want to walk you through how this will look. So for you, let's go to my old Universal Analytics account here. You'll probably see this thing here where they're like, hey, this is about to be deleted. What is going on? What you're going to want to do is go to admin right here. And if you're in this view, already have an account. I've called this Google Analytics account my business name, which is Jamar Diggs, or what I want to call it is Jamar Diggs. And then what you would create is then a property. And the property is almost like the website that you want to monitor. So think of it as almost like an umbrella. You don't need too many accounts. Think of your account as your business. My business is JDiggs Media. I probably should have called my account JDiggs Media. And then my property, Jamar Diggs website or jamardiggs.com, like how I did right here. Google Analytics makes it very easy for you to transition if you have had Universal Analytics. So you could literally just go through this GA4 setup assistant and it will take you through everything that you need to. Okay. But you see how it's hey, you already connected it. So you don't have to do that anymore, but it literally will walk you through exactly what you need to do. Now, if for some reason this is not happening for you, all you have to do is go to create new property right here, and you will be automatically pushed to create a new Google Analytics 4 property right here. And so, like I said before, you will just name this property and then choose your currency. To be honest with you, this is the same setup. If something has happened, right? And you're like, whatever Google Analytics you're in right now, you don't like it, you could do this exact same thing from the very beginning, right? So right now we're creating just a property, but let's just say we go back and for some reason you're like, I wanna actually just create a whole new account. Let's go back into this admin section here, and we just want to create a whole new account. Then you would just do, it would be something like, it'd be your business name right here. These things are normally fine. And then you see now we're creating a property. So you see how easy that is. And then the property would be the Jamar Diggs website. Press next. We'll put in the category. Let's just do business small. Okay, cool. Now when we go here, what I have now is a general baseline of analytics, but what basically happens is that the data just looks a little bit different. So if you check these right here, the data just will look a little bit different, but just for the sake of the examples and for this series that I'm doing, this is going to be one out of three videos that I do. So I just want everything to just show the same. I have the baseline report, so let's just use that for right now. I have already reviewed this, so I already know that I want to accept it, but you definitely read it. This is gonna be where we start collecting the data. And so we're gonna choose the platform, which is my website. We're gonna select my website URL. And so my website URL is jamardiggs.com, the stream names, and then we're going to go ahead and normally I leave all the stuff just as it is. So we'll just do jamardiggs.com, create a stream. And so now we are ready to collect data. You see right here where it actually gives you the information of how to install this into your builders. And so you can already show how you can do it for Wix or for Shopify, Squarespace. Let's actually do the Shopify one. So it shows you everything that you need to do right here. It makes it very, very easy. Follow all of the stuff that it gives you. But just to show you, I have Wix, Showit, and Shopify pulled up just to kind of show you how it will probably look behind the scenes. So now you have everything that you need to set up to actually like connect this Google Analytics account to your website. And the way that we're going to be doing that is with this code right here, this measurement ID. They call it like a G code. In the past, your Google Analytics code for universal analytics used to start with a UA. This is a G code. The easiest way to add it to your website is with this G code. Now, for other platforms, you may need to insert a piece of code, and that kind of code is going to be found down here where you insert it manually, okay? And so this is going to be where you insert it manually. So this is going to be like this little code that you would use to put in the head element of each of your website. I don't use Wix anymore, but I want to show you, like, once you log into Wix, all you will have to do, there's two ways to add this code to your website. And so the first way is through the marketing section here, and it says Google Analytics. Okay. And so when you click on this, it takes you through an easy setup process to add this. So obviously this is not an active account. Just have to do two things to set it up, and it's so great, right? So all you have to do is set up your Google Analytics property ID, which we already did. And then you're going to add your Google Analytics ID to your site. And all you have to do is when you press this, it should just allow you to take this measurement ID and paste it in there or connect it in that way. Okay. The other way that you could do this is by going into settings and going into custom code. You see, I've done it before with Universal Analytics. Wix has it separated by the head section, the body, and the body start and the body end. You could literally go to add custom code right here and then select where you want it to be, then give it a little name, and then paste that little code inside that box. Okay. Now, when it comes to Shopify, what you're going to want to do is you're going to want to log into your Shopify account and search for Google. It'll be Google and YouTube. And when you click on that, you should be taken to a little section like here underneath your sales channels section here. And then you're going to want to add it to your settings right here. And you'll be able to add your Google Analytics property just like that. Right now, you'll see that I have it connected. And then for Showit, they make it very, very easy. The way that I have it set up right now is you just go to your site settings here. You go to third party and then Google Analytics, and it is right here, right there for you. But yeah, after that, you are good to go. It is now installed. You have now created your Google Analytics account. You created your property. Now you have gone ahead and added that code to your website. Another thing that I want to show you, possibly how to add it to your landing pages as well. So if you're using something like Thrivecart and you're using checkout pages, this is going to be where you add it as well. So let me show you that too. I am in one of my products inside of Thrivecart. The place where you would add your Google Analytics tracking, I believe it is underneath checkout and tracking right here. And this is going to be where you will add your Google Analytics ID here, right? And so you're going to want to make sure that you are adding the GA4 one. And all you would just have to do, go here and add it there. And then you're good to go. And then you just save it and get the URL. Most landing pages have it very easy just like that. If you go to tracking, they'll say integrate with Google Analytics or something like that, and you just add it. So it's very important for if you want to track the website traffic that goes to any page that you own, even if it's not a web page on your actual website, then you need to make sure that you are adding either the G code or you are taking that HTML code and that custom code and putting it on that page as well. But you have to either use the G code or adding in that code snippet.
So now you have the very first step in understanding your data when it comes to your marketing efforts. If you want access to all of these trainings at one time, along with a lot of other resources to help you launch and grow your channel and measure your results, I definitely invite you to join the Little Lift Club. The information to the YouTube community is going to be in the description down below. If you like this video, let me know by giving it a like, taking a screenshot, sharing it on Instagram. Do whatever you need to do to tell the girls that you just got so much helpful information from your one and only favorite, Jamar. And I will see you in the next video. Bye-bye.